So, unfortunately, one of my potatoes hit the button, and this video started again. So again, what I'm doing today is I'm making beef ribs, which I've never done before. I put it in the slow cooker with barbecue sauce, beef broth, honey, bay leaf, garlic, of course. I have to put garlic and everything. And I let it simmer in this for about 4 or 5 hours. And they're just about done. And now I'm making these potatoes that I just cut up. And like I was saying, I got this. This is the best potato peeler. The guy who sold this is not around anymore. He's an old guy, passed away. He bought these from overseas somewhere. And he used to sell them in the street for $3 each and 2 for $5. And he used to be well-dressed in a gray suit. And he would bring this big basin and vegetables. And he would peel them right in front of people in the streets. And he would sell them in the streets. And I tell you, this thing is like, look at this. It's crazy. Look at this. You can't peel potato faster than this. You just can't. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Okay, look at that. And you can see some parts that are black. Look at that. Look at that potato, look at that. I'm gonna cut it into quarters. Using my Cyco knife. Okay. Into the pot. I'm gonna show you how it's done one more time. Look at that. Look how fast you peel potatoes. It's just, you can peel hundreds of potatoes. And this thing, this blade is Swiss, will never go dull. I've had this for years. I treasure this thing. I bought other potato peelers from stores and never get this type of peeling action. You can never get it, I'm telling you. Too bad this guy's gone dead. Anyway, this is the potato. Cut it in quarters. Down the line, down the line. Into the pot, okay? Okay. Like I said, I got beef short ribs, slowly simmered in barbecue sauce and beef stock. So, I'm going with the real mashed potatoes. I'm not using artificial mashed potatoes. And I might as well go with the fresh corn. Now, frozen corn is okay. I mean, I've been eating it for years. You know, Green Giant, sweet corn. Love it. But I saw these and they look so beautiful that I bought them. I bought a pack of them. And you can't beat, you know, fresh corn. You know, because when you freeze something, it actually loses the taste. No matter what you do or process, it's not the same as having fresh corn. So, we're having fresh corn, mashed potatoes, and beef short ribs. And it's going to look good. It's looking good. And I'm going to show you in a few minutes how these beef ribs are looking already. So, folks, look at my... I'm going to show you my ribs. These things are falling off the bone. I mean, they've been cooking since 11:30 in the slow cooker. Let me show you. Look at this. Matter of fact, look at this bone that just fell off. I tried to pick up a piece of meat and the bone came right off. Yeah, that's not a piece of wood, it's a piece of bone. And these things look delicious. And they're in the barbecue sauce. It's got barbecue sauce, honey, I put bay leaf in there, I put beef stock, and I slowly simmered them. And I put them in there 11:30, and it's almost 6:30, and they've been in there ever since. And now they just are low, warming up, and they should be nice and tender. And it's the first time I'm cooking beef ribs, so bear with me. So again, once again, today's menu, beef ribs, short beef ribs, homemade mashed potatoes, fresh corn on the cob. That's it. Sounds good to me. Talk to you guys soon. So, folks, I have a little bit of an appetizer. You've probably never seen this. You probably have. It's prosciutto with melon, cantaloupe. Prosciutto with cantaloupe. Gives you that nice, the cantaloupe gives it that sweet flavor. definitely sweet taste, and the prosciutto gives it a nice salty smoked dried flavor, and it looks like this. Let me show you.
Yep, folks, and this is how it looks. Prosciutto with cantaloupe. Delicious. So yeah, folks, this is what it is. And once again, in case you're wondering what that is, it's prosciutto with cantaloupe. And the cantaloupe, of course, gives it that sweet flavor, and then the salty flavor comes from the dried Italian imported prosciutto. So let's go. Let me go and go to the table and eat this before he eats it all.
Delicious. Delicious. I wish you were here to try this. Cantaloupe wrapped with prosciutto. Delicious. Mm. Too bad you're not here. Delicioso.
So I got my mashed potatoes.
Oh, not mashed yet,
but they are going to be mashed in a few minutes. What I want to do is I want to put some butter in here. Put about 2 teaspoons of butter. This is what I got left here. And I'm going to use some milk to soften it up. I'm going to start off with a little bit, and then I'll adjust. Okay, and I start to smash. Okay, there we go. And I put more milk if I want it more creamier. And of course, it definitely has to be more creamier than this. And more milk. It becomes more creamier. Okay. Now it's starting to look like something. Okay. Remember, you can't boil the potatoes too long because then you're going to get mush. So you got to get them just right, 20 minutes. About 15, 20 minutes. I don't know. I just want to make sure that I get all of them. And then, of course, to soften them up, you add the milk. And a trick to this is you should warm up the milk. Warm up the milk so that when you draw it into the potatoes, it doesn't get the potatoes cold. Right? Warm up the milk. Putting more milk in there because I want it more creamier. And then we're going to smash. Now it's starting to look like the consistency that I'm looking for, which is like this, mashed like that. Okay. That's the consistency I'm looking for. You know, I mean, it's up to you. You can add stuff to it right now. So I've if you roast garlic with some olive oil and you dump it in here, it's delicious. And if you want to put some cheddar cheese, also shredded cheddar cheese, this is the time to do it. And you have some nice cheesy mashed potatoes. But right now, today, I'm just doing regular mashed potatoes. And I'm looking for the right consistency, which is just about done. And let me sneak a finger in there. Definitely need salt. Don't be scared to put the salt in. You can always leave the salt out and let your guest, you know, salt their own potatoes. They might, you know, that's the best thing to do, but okay. And if you put enough butter in there, salted butter, the butter will give it flavor. Let me try this out. Good. Nice and good.
So, keep smashing. We taste this once again. We wash this. Wash the fork. This is nice and soft. And they're great. In fact, let me add some. I'm going to add some. A little more drop of milk. So we get it more, a little bit more creamier. And that's it. I'm done with that. There you go. And that should be it. That should be it. Yep. Okay. Should be it. Now, put this, cover that up, on top of my stove, keep it nice and warm, and then it should be in a few minutes. So, my corn on the cob is done. I'm gonna take it out. I got these nice plates. These plates are for, I guess I bought them. I used to work part time in CVS, and it was. At the end of the season, they were like $1.30 for. So I bought two of them. I use them for ice cream, and I use them for corn on the cob. So I boil my corn on the cob for like 10 minutes. I let it rest for 5. And look at that. Nice. Look at that, nice. It fits right in. And there we go. Okay, let me take these to the table. Well, folks, these ribs, the bones fell right off. I'm picking them out of the pot, and the bones are falling off. I got a pot full of bones, and the meat is coming out. So I'm about to serve it, and you're going to see how it looks. Well, folks, my dinner is done. The ribs, I put them in like for, I don't know what it was, 5 hours or so, and they cooked so well that it fell off the bone. And they look delicious. So let me show you what's at the table today. So we got our little mini croissants there, warm. We got our corn on the cob, and we got some butter there. And we have, and the main course, here we go. Homemade mashed potatoes and beef ribs that were simmered. The beef ribs were simmered in barbecue sauce, beef stock, bay leaves, garlic, no salt. Everything was in the stock, and simmered for, like I said, 4 or 5 hours. I've lost track, but they are falling off the bone. Let me see if I can show you here in the pot. If I look at the pot here, let me just try to. All you see is a bunch of bones. There you go, bones. See, these bones coming off. They just came right off. Look at that. So I ended up with a bunch of bones, but shows you. Shows you how tender it is. Anyway, folks, thank you for being here with me today, like always. And today is Sunday. Tomorrow's the start of a new week, and hopefully this nightmare will be over soon. Let's have some faith. And anyway, folks, thank you always for being with me and all that good stuff. And love you guys. And see you tomorrow.